Welcome to Good Shepherd. If you're our guest here, please pick up an informational packet at the back door. We have Pastor Tammy Dalveg here as Kathy is out with Stu for his treatments. So keep them in your prayers. Our temple talk today will be from Darren Magnuson.
Stewardship, a gift of more than just money. This is evident to me as I was growing up, and there was a family in our church that couldn't give as much as they financially thought they should. And as a result, they took on a major program in our church and donated their services back to that. And as a result, stewardship to me is a gift of oneself to the church in whatever capacity that takes. Thank you.
I'd like to invite you to stand and to turn to page 94 for the brief order for confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin and whose mercy endures forever.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Gracious God, have mercy on us. We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith.
Amen.
Our opening hymn is 665.
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Please join in the hymn of praise, which is in the front of the red hymnal, page 204. Join in the prayer of the day as printed in your bulletin. Almighty and everlasting God, increase in us your gift of faith that, forsaking what lies behind and reaching out to what lies ahead, we may follow the way of your commandments and receive the crown of everlasting joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated. Today's choir anthem is Seek Ye First the Kingdom of God. Today's scripture will be read by Isla Teske.
Please read the psalm responsibly. The psalm is from chapter 90, verses 12 through 17. So teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. Satisfy us by your steward love in the morning, so shall we rejoice and be glad in all our days. Show your servants your works and your splendor to your children. The lesson is from Hebrews 4, verses 12 through 16. We cannot hide our thoughts, desires, and actions from God, to whom we are completely accountable. Nevertheless, Jesus understands our human weaknesses and temptations, because he also experienced them. Therefore, we can approach the throne of grace to receive divine mercy from Christ. The lesson. Indeed, the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing until it divides our soul from spirit, joints from marrow. It is able to judge the thoughts and intentions of the heart. And before him, no creation is hidden, but all are naked and lay bare to the eyes of the one to whom we must render an account. Since then, we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast to our confession. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore approach the throne of grace with boldness, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need.
Please stand if you're able for the gospel acclamation in the front of the red hymnal, page 205.
Eternal life. Jesus said to him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness. You shall not defraud. Honor your mother and your father." He said to him, "Teacher, I have kept all these since my youth." And Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said, "You lack one thing. Go, sell what you own and give the money to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. And then come, follow me." When he heard this, he was shocked and went away grieving, for he had many possessions. Then Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "How hard it will be for those who have wealth to enter the kingdom of God." And the disciples were perplexed at these words. But Jesus said to them again, "Children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God." They were greatly astounded and said to one another, "Then who can be saved?" And Jesus looked at them and said, "For mortals it is impossible, but not for God. For God all things are possible." And Peter began to say to him, "Look, we have left everything and followed you." And Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, there is no one who has left house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or fields for my sake and for the sake of the good news, who will not receive 100-fold now in this age, houses, brothers and sisters, mothers and children, and fields with persecutions, and in the age to come, eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last will be first." The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated.
We'll now have special music from the Crossroads students.
If you know any of these songs, feel free to sing along with us.
Oh,
Would you guys come over here? Do we have any children here this morning? There's a brave guy. Anybody else? Anybody else want to come up? Okay. We are going to have kind of a different type of children's sermon this morning, okay? I need to get you guys through the eye of the needle. Okay? We need a needle. Maybe you guys could be part of the needle, too. Okay. There. Okay. All right, there you go. There's the eye. Come on. You want to try? Do you? Okay, lower the eye. There you go. Good. Oh, you broke the needle. That's okay. Do you want to go through too? No? Thank you for going through the eye of the needle. Tell me, did you guys think you were going to be able to do it right away? Did you think you could do it? Did you? Yeah? How about if it was a real needle? Do you think you could do it then? No? How come? Because, yeah, the eye of the needle would be too small, right? Okay. In the gospel reading today, Jesus talks about how hard it is for us to truly love God and to do what God wants us to do. Do you guys think it's hard to love God and do everything God wants us to do, or easy? Hard? How about you? Easy, is it? Oh, good for you. I'm happy for you. But for most people, it's kind of hard. And, you know, we want to do the right thing all the time, and we want to love people, but sometimes we're tired and we're cranky, or we just really decide we don't want to love somebody, and we make mistakes, and sometimes we don't even realize that we're doing bad things until after we've done them. Then we feel really bad about it. You know what Jesus says, though? With God, all things are possible. Okay? That means you could go through the eye of a needle. Can you believe that? Sure you can. Sure you can. With God? With God? God can do everything, right? So you could. That's the right answer. Nod your head. Yeah. Good. With God, all things are possible, guys. So don't forget that, okay? You probably haven't ever done anything you feel totally terrible about yet, but maybe someday you will. And when you do, just remember that Jesus loves you and Jesus forgives you. And when Jesus died on the cross, all of your sins were totally, completely, forever forgiven. And just like a camel couldn't go through the eye of a needle without God's help, so you couldn't be perfect without God's help or enter the kingdom of God without God's help. But with God's help, you can. Just like with God's help, even a camel could go through the eye of a needle. Okay? Thanks for coming up. You can go back. Thank you guys for being a good needle.
This is one of my favorite gospel readings. Not only because it's fun to have a children's sermon where kids go through the eye of a needle, but because I love this story. It is so true to me. What you find as you read the gospels is that there are a few stories that are told in only one gospel. There are some stories that are told in two of the Gospels. There are some that are told in three. And there are a few things that are described in four. How many of the Gospels do you think talk about this story? Tell us this story. How many think it's only one? How many think it's two? How many think it's three? How many think it's four? It's three. Matthew, Mark, and Luke all talk about this story, and they all give us different details. And it's really interesting to read Mark's. It's also really interesting to read Matthew's and Luke's. I believe that it is Matthew's that gives us a pertinent piece of information that Mark's doesn't. This is a young man. This is a young man. He is rich and he is young. And he is looking for a good teacher because he has a really, really important question to ask. And his question is, what's the secret? What is it that I need to do to be right with God? To be the best that God wants me to be? To love God, to follow God, to serve God? And Jesus tells him, well, you know everything you're supposed to do, right? And he lists some of the commandments. And the man says, I've done all those things. From the time I was very, very young, I've done all those things. And Jesus says, all right then. If you want the truest possible relationship with God, here's what you do. You take everything you have, you sell it, you give the money away, and you come and follow me. And the man is shocked, and he goes away grieving. You can't do that. Imagine, how many of you are married? Please raise your hand if you're married. Okay. Say, what would have happened if the first time you met your spouse, okay? The very first time you met your spouse, you had looked at that person, and that person had looked at you, and that person had told you this, I want you to give up having a claim on your own money. I want you to give up having your own house. I want you to give up being able to set your own schedule and always coordinate your schedule with mine. I want you to always think about everything that I want and need before you ever make a single decision. How many of you would have, the very first time you met this person, said, sign me up, huh? Anybody? No, that isn't how relationships usually work. We don't count the cost until we've sort of decided we want to proceed and go forward with it. But marriage is nothing compared to children. How many of you have children? Okay, imagine that you are in the doctor's office and you've just found out that you are going to have a child, and you have a conversation with your unborn child. And your child tells you, I'm going to cost you about $250,000 by the time I'm done. And you know, college is going up, so it might even be more than that. And you know, you're not gonna get much sleep for, you know, 4 or 5 years, because I'm gonna wake up in the night and I'm gonna cry, and you're gonna feel guilty if you don't come in and pay attention to me. You're never gonna be able to eat the dinner food that you want, because I like macaroni and cheese, and so we're gonna need to have that a lot, and frozen pizza. And daycare. You're gonna have to drive quite a ways to drop me off in the morning, and then I'm gonna cry, and I'm gonna make you feel really, really guilty. you're gonna have to come pick me up after work, or you're gonna have to stop working and stay home with me and never have a moment of peace to yourself, because you'll always be focusing on me. And even if you're at work, you're still gonna always be focusing on me. Oh, and one more thing. Every time anyone does anything that hurts me, it's gonna hurt you worse than it hurts me. Okay. What would you have said if you had this conversation with your unborn child before the child was even born? Sign me up? Oh. Would have thought about it, right? If you still had an option, you would have thought about it. You still had a choice. When you saw your spouse for the first time, you didn't just jump in and get married right away. At least most people don't do that. You thought about it. You took some time with it. Here is why I love this gospel reading. First of all, it's honest about the fact that we don't want to pay the price. No one here wants to follow Christ the way that we need to, the way that we know we need to. It's honest about that. Second reason that I really love it is that since I've been doing campus ministry, I've been doing a lot of work with people like this young man. He is a young man. He is looking for a good teacher, and he has important questions. Thank you so much for your support that makes it possible for me to be at MSU in Mankato and to be someone that young people looking for good teachers with important questions can come to, and we can talk. And I can, on your behalf and with your support, talk about Christ to these people. And you know how it works. First of all, we learn about Christ in Sunday school or whatever education we have. Then perhaps we have confirmation. Then perhaps we have high school youth group. Then perhaps we have college ministry. Then perhaps we have children of our own and we're in the church. And I don't think that most of us ever get this just exactly right. But there is a sense in which practice makes perfect. And the more accustomed we become to Christ in the church, the more we realize that this cost of following Christ is perhaps worth it. The more we sense and taste his loveliness and his beauty, the more we are entranced and want to follow him. So thank you for making it possible for me to be at MSU in Mankato and to work with people like these so that they don't slide through the cracks, so that they can retain a connection with the church while they're in college. I'm going to invite a couple of the students. Sarah Schaff is our worship leader, and Chris Myers is a grad student. And you guys are going to need to find a mic. So, oh, yep, that one, perfect. Good.
Well, hello, I'm Sarah, like Tammy said, and I'm also a resident at Crossroads. I live in the apartment upstairs. We have a lot of opportunities for people to come into our building. We do things like Lunch for a Buck. It's for all students. Pretty much a lot of people on campus know about it now. And we've had a lot more people this year than last year. We just have a kitchen downstairs, so we cook the meals. So they get a home-cooked meal for just a dollar. So it's really nice for college students because food gets people in the building and it's also cheap for them, so it works out really nice. And then we get to talk and meet new people, and for the first time, that could be the first time that these people are walking in a church door. So I just think it's really cool and a really neat opportunity. We also do things like free yoga, you know, also other ways to just try to get students in our building. But then we also have a service on Wednesday nights, our worship service. And we take communion, we do some worship, like some of the songs that you heard us sing. And yeah, Tammy gives a good sermon, and it's always applicable to our lives. And so it's just a fantastic way for students to encounter Christ for the first time if they haven't before. I also want to talk about some things that we did last year. We did this thing called Worship Band Fest, where we combined campus ministries and where we all got together and our bands played different songs and stuff. And we also had Week of Work, where we did some service projects to give back to our community around the Mankato area, because people give so much and we just want to be able to be a blessing to our community and to you guys and to whoever. You know, we just, God has given us a lot, and we want to thank you so much for your support, because you're supporting a ministry that's growing in Christ, and thank you so much for that.
Yeah, like Tammy said, I'm Chris. I'm a graduate student at MSU. Most of the students that come in through Crossroads are undergrads, and so I guess I'm a little bit of an outlier in the congregation, but I definitely have found a good home at Crossroads. It's a little bit different than churches in the community in that it's focused specifically on college students, which typically tends to be an unchurched population. So it's really good to have people that might not be more of the traditional churchgoer, to have a contemporary service for them to go to, and to have some Bible studies that are focused on them as a community. And it is a great community of people to be a part of. I particularly engage in, I play bass in the worship band, so we have kind of a rocky contemporary worship going, but we still have good Lutheran roots. So we are very thankful for any support that has been given and will be given to us in the future. We thank you for any support that you can give, and we're very glad to be a part of this, a part of the ELCA, and to be supported. Thank you.
So now you can see why I love my job. We'll be available to talk after coffee if you have any questions about Crossroads or if you just want to visit with some of the students. So thank you.
Oh, I was going to announce the hymn too.
It's number 685, and we'll sing verses 1, 3, 5, and 6. 685.
Please stand if you're able. Join in the Apostles' Creed as printed in your bulletin. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended in heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated for the offering, where we're given the opportunity to give back to God what he has first given us. We'll have special music by the Crossroads students. The offertory response is, "We give thee but thine own," verse 1, 2, and 4 in the ELW, page 686. The day. You may remain seated or kneel. The response is, "Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer." As disciples of Christ Jesus, called to love and serve all people, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. Good teacher, your word is living and active in the church. By your Spirit, give us the will to leave behind those things that hold us back from following you and serving others. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, our treasure, help us cherish your gift of creation and be good stewards of all you provide. Lord, in your mercy, make your church into a house of wisdom, inviting all to live with simplicity and to walk in the way of insight. We pray for the congregations in Wells and these Southeast Minnesota congregations, St. John's Lutheran in Kasson, Redeemer Lutheran in Alden, Our Savior Lutheran in Keister, St. Peter Lutheran in Northfield. Lord, in your mercy, that our campus ministry settings encourage others to follow in the path of Jesus. Today we remember St. Olaf College student congregation in Northfield, Winona State University Campus Ministry, and Mankato State University Campus Ministry. Lord, in your mercy, God of hosts, you demand justice and hate oppression. Give the world honest leaders who speak the truth. Uphold the rights of the poor and work for the good of all. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, with boldness we pray for those who suffer adversity, addiction, alienation, or illness, especially Shannon Royce, Jan Helfritz, Stu Fullerton, John Musser, Karen Evans, Gary Salisbury, Bill Niebuhr, Chuck Dunbar, Edie Zabel, and those we name silently in our hearts. Give them mercy and help in time of need. Lord, in your mercy. Son of God, our great high priest, direct the spiritual life of this congregation that we may continually seek you in prayer, praise, and service. Lord, in your mercy, we rejoice with the saints who lived steadfastly in your love and now rest in your peace. We look to the day when we too will praise you face to face. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers, faithful God, and renew us by your Spirit, that we may joyfully love and serve you and one another through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Peace, please stand and join in the sharing of God's peace.
Continue with the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
right to give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for our Savior Jesus Christ. Fulfilling the promise of the resurrection, you pour out the fire of your Spirit, uniting in one body people of every nation and tongue. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant, shed in my blood for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." And as we remember that night and his sacrifice for us, we pray together the prayer he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. This is the body of Christ. This is Christ's body given to me. This is Christ's body given to you. Thank you. Please stand for the blessing. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace unto eternal life, and may you be filled with his peace. Amen. Let us pray. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. In your mercy, strengthen us through this gift, in faith toward you, and in fervent love toward one another, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
There are baskets at the entrance if you wish to make a donation to continue the work of Crossroads and sharing God's love. Immediately following the service, coffee will be served in the social hall. And since you have time before the Vikings game or need another cup of coffee, remember the pancake breakfast at the local fire hall. It goes till 12:30 today. Please join in the sending song, "The Spirit Sends Us Forth to Serve," in the ELW number 551.